out there may not be as well versed in the classics as we are.
And to that, we say, Mom, Dad, family, friends, hello. We take class at the Gamut Theater. In New Orleans, classic theater is their jam.
But that's okay. We forgive you.
In fact, we would like to take this opportunity to dive into some of our favorite stories with you.
So I could go through all the Shakespeare stories. We're going to take a look at a wider range.
Because storytelling has been around for as long as humans have existed.
And if we didn't have the awesome stories from days past, we'd never have gotten the modern tales we've grown to know and love.
Like West Side Story.
10 Things I Hate About You.
Lion King.
You guys, we just told him it wasn't all Shakespeare.
Right? So let's get rolling, shall we?
What be a lady tonight? Get out of my sight.
There's no crying in theater.
Yes, ma'am.
Anyway, as you were saying, let's dive into our first tale.
Little Red Riding Hood.
Do you guys know how many versions there are in this story? We use the Grimm Brothers version today. The origins go back to the 10th century in France.
But weren't the Grimm Brothers like 1800 and in Germany?
Yeah, and pretty much every culture has their own version.
There's an old Italian version where Little Red gets tricked by an ogre.
In China, they used to say she was tricked by a tiger.
La 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 la, the forest is sure lovely today.
Oh girl, no.
Please be careful.
Woodcutter will come to meet you and you can walk together. You're much too young to walk by yourself. Stay on the path and do not talk to strangers.
You got it, Mom.
I mean it, young lady. The world isn't as nice as you hope it could be.
You know, I could wait for the woodcutter, but I don't want Grandmother to be alone. I'll be fine.
So, Little Red Riding Hood skips off into the forest alone?
Yup.
Even though she's never been that far into the woods alone before?
Yup.
And isn't she like 7?
Well, that is up to interpretation. She's said to be a young girl. So, Red is skipping through the woods, and she's staying on the path, and everything's fine. Until...
Why, hello, little girl. Where might you be heading?
Creeper?
Well, hello. I'm sorry, sir, but my mom told me not to talk to strangers, so...
But I'm no...
Close one.
But I'm no stranger. Don't you remember me? I was close by to you and your mother.
Oh, really? Well, gee, maybe you can help me.
Oh. So Red told the wolf where she was heading. He cut through the woods.
But...
Wait.
What?
I got to Granny's house first.
Hi, Granny!
What?
You're mine!
Oh no!
Wolf swallowed her whole and awaited Little Red. Dressed in Granny's spare clothes, he hid.
Grandmother, I'm here!
Why come in, dear?
Grandmother sounds terrible. Grandmother! My... What big ears you have!
What's the matter to hear you with, my dear?
Grandmother! What big arms you have!
Well, thanks, Kaylin. No, I've been hitting the gym.
Jail!
Fine.
I mean, the better to hug you with, my dear.
Grandmother! We need to talk to your dentist. Stat! What big teeth you have!
Mwah!
Now they're sitting cramped, as you can imagine, in this wolf's stomach together. And just when it seemed like all hope was lost, that noble woodcutter we heard about at the beginning of the story bursts in to save the day.
Hey, yo! Somebody call for a hero?
Listen up, wolf!
No worries, ma'am. All in a fairy tale forest, man's day's work. But you, little Red, how are you holding up?
How she's holding up? Who cares? She deserves the longest timeout of the century. This is nuts. This miniature deviant deliberately disobeyed her mother's thoughtful instructions. Snuck out into the woods like a maniac, talked to a stranger, and put her and her grandmother in danger with her own naivety. And if it weren't for this random guy just showing up, they both would have been digested within a day.
Maya, that's why this story is so important. Why it's stuck around for hundreds of years.
And why each culture around the world tells it in a different way that's relatable to them as kids.
I never realized how important it was for me to listen to my mom and how deceitful strangers with bad intentions could be. He seemed like such a nice guy. We're lucky you saved us, Woodcutter. Thank you.
Okay. I like the wonderful fuzzies, I do. But I'll be honest, I don't love that Grandmother, Little Red, and Mom are all defenseless women in this story and need one man to save them.
Well, see, there are some early French versions of the story where Little Red saves her and her grandmother with her own wit merit and is depicted as more of a young lady heroine.
Let's see that!
Rewind!
Crap, the closet. Here she is, quick, in the sky.
Grandmother, it is I. Grandmother, you look so.
Wow, this cold has really gotten you down.
Yes, dear, it's awful, but please, come in.
Grandmother, I've been skimming all day, and I came across a single ye old outhouse. Can't wait to spend quality time together, but before we do, can I use the bathroom first? Please!
Well, alright.
Thanks, Grandmother! The little red walked behind your grandmother's cottage and saw an axe on a nearby stump.
Hey! That's mine!
Little Red took the axe and smashed through the back of her grandmother's cottage to help her get out. The wolf was so busy dreaming of ways to cook up the little girl, he missed their grand escape.
Good work, Little Red. Now tell me, did you still learn our lesson?
For sure. Grandmother and I are definitely going to be taking some self-defense classes at the line.
It's fun to stay at the line. It's fun to stay at the line. Why? They said YMCA. It's a classic hit, but not a musical. I'm abiding by the rules.
I think the 1970s are just a bit too modern for us today.
Challenge accepted.
So Little Red has taught generation after generation to listen to your parents, not talk to strangers, and have an air of caution as you make your way through life.
Ironically, the protagonists in Shakespeare's most beloved tragedy, Romeo and Juliet, do pretty much the opposite. Not all stories are created equal. That's Romeo, a Montague.
Did my heart love till now? Forswear at sight, I ne'er saw true beauty till this night.
Fetch me my rapier, boy. Now I have stopped in honor of my kin to strike him dead. I hold it not sin.
Why, how now, kinsman? Wherefore storm you so?
That's Tybalt and Lord Capulet. They're Capulets, obviously.
The Montagues and the Capulets have an epic feud, meaning they hated each other longer than anyone can remember and refused to talk it out. The last people died. Very touchy subject.
Okay, this is a Montague, our foe, a villain that is hypocrites. To scorn our solemnity this night.
Young Romeo, is it?
Is he? That villain, Romeo.
Content thee, gentle cuz. Let him alone.
And, to say truth, Verona brags of him to be a virtuous and well-governed youth. Therefore, be patient. Take no note of him.
This scene is crazy for a lot of reasons, and this is one of them. Lord Capulet isn't known for being one of the most
isn't known for being the most gentle dude in Verona, but he tells Tybalt for tonight, have peace.
It fits. When such a villain is a guest, I'll not endure him.
He shall be endured. Am I the master here or you? Go to.
Oop.
And
I will withdraw. But this little intrusion shall now seeming sweet convert to bitter gall.
Tybalt exits in a cloud of moodiness that can only be matched by a 17-year-old whose mom will let her borrow the minivan.
But Mom, there's this thing and everybody else is going.
I'm staying with my unworthiest hand.
Wait! Wait, you guys! This is important. It is the coolest literary flirtation ever.
If I were staying with my unworthiest hand, this holy shrine, the gentle fine as this, my lips two belching pilgrims ready stand, to smooth that rough touch with a tender kiss.
Did you hear what Romeo just did? He didn't speak in normal verse, but instead, he approached this girl to party with a poem, A-B-A-B rhyming. And what does she do?
Good pilgrim, you do wrong your hand too much. Which mannerly devotion shows in this? Four saints have hands that pilgrim's hands do touch, and palm to palm is holy palmer's kiss.
Oh, snap. CB rhyming. She is so clever.
Have not seen lips and holy palmers too?
I, pilgrim, lips that they must use in prayer.
Oh, then, dear saint, let lips do what hands do. They pray, dread thou, lest faith turn to despair.
And now they're completing each other's rhymes? Finished with witty jests?
Saints do not move, though grand pilgrims say.
Then move not. My prayers affect that tape.
Oh, man! It's a sonnet? These two people are so smart, witty, and in love that they use the most difficult poetic devices as pickup lines?
By yours, my sin is purged.
And have my lips, the sin that they have took.
Sin from thy lips, O trespass, sweetly urged.
Madam, your mother brings a word with you.
Claire said what?
They were starting another sonnet. They're going to continue flirting in sonnets.
What is her mother?
Mary Batchelor. Her mother is the lady of the house. Oh, and a good lady, and wise, and virtuous. I nursed her daughter that you talk with all.
Is she a Capulet? Oh, dear account, my life is my foe's debt.
I thank you, honest gentlemen. Good night.
Come hither, nurse. What is yon gentleman?
His name is Romeo, Anna Montague, the only son of your great enemy.
My only love sprung from my only hate, too early seen unknown, and known too late.
The sonnet is just the beginning. Mercutio, the Marlon Brando of Verona, has all kinds of crazy imagery. Meanwhile, Juliet's just trying to dodge the love of Paris because she thinks he's a total Rick Moranis. When in reality, he's an absolute Ryan Gosling. Her life would be so much easier if she just chose him, but she doesn't. She fights for love.
And as the play goes on, Romeo's language continues to grow, just like his love for Juliet.
It is the East, and Juliet is the Sun.
But she's only 14. Can 14-year-olds be that smart?
Excuse me!
Have you ever composed a sonnet with someone you just met at a party?
Point taken.
We now move from the streets of Verona and into the darkness of one's own mind. Drew, nervous, very, very dreadfully nervous I have been and am. But why do you say that I am mad? The disease had sharpened my senses, not destroyed, not dulled them. Above all was the sense of hearing acute.
Edgar Allan Poe's short story, The Telltale Heart, has haunted readers since 1843.
Object there was none. Passion there was none. I loved the old man. He had never wronged me. He had never given me insult. For his gold, I had no desire. I think it was his eye. Yes, it was this. He had the eye of a vulture. Whatever fell upon me, my blood ran cold. I made up my mind to take the life of the old man.
Oh, hello there! How have you been? What weather we've had!
I was never kind to the old man during the whole week before I got killed.
Sleeping all right, you?
Each night I watched, and on the eighth night the deed was done. Easy, really.
Oh yeah, not mad at all. He hid him among the floorboards and left no stain behind. But there was a knocking.
What am I to fear?
We've been dispatched to search the premises. A neighborhood shriek?
Ah, the shriek was mine. A dream, I'm afraid. A nightmare. But please, officers, do search the premises.
Thank you.
Thank you. And where do you think he welcomed them? Set up the chairs?
But, as they forgot their suspicion and chatted merrily, the madman grew agitated.
Excuse me, my headaches, it is so late.
I get headaches at night all the time, half for years.
No.
His agitation grew, and he raved and ranted, swore and huffed. He sweeped the room with fury and terror, but the officers continued the chat.
There was a ringing in his ears, which grew to a thumping. A sound so familiar, he heard in the presence of the old man.
The beating of his heart.
I haunted him. He could not escape.
Anything is more tolerable than this derision. I feel that I just screamed out or died. Feel it tear the place. Here is the beating of his hideous.
What are you doing?
I'm the Raven. See? Poe's most famous Raven. That's me.
Mr. Ross, you were going through the Telltale Heart.
Yeah, and the Raven in the Telltale Heart.
No, there's no Raven in the Telltale Heart. Those are two different stories. Actually, one is a poem.
You know what? I think you guys need to lighten up. Hey, Michelle, is this part of the show over yet? Because I think the audience is ready for some improv!
Alligator. Your suggestion is alligator, whatever that means to you.
No, I'm an alligator.
There are no alligators in the Lion King. There are no alligators in the magic school bus.
For the game.
We can make one.
This is science class, honey. Alligators don't come till 8th grade.
You sure are.
I'm sorry, but I cannot believe that a three-year-old is taller than a three-year-old is taller than an eighth grader is taller than a mouse. I'm sorry, but we're gonna focus on the ABCs, okay?
Fine.
Now, can you tell me the first three? One, two, three.
Letters.
Letters.
I like pizza.
I'm sorry. Repeat it again.
I like pepperoni.
You know that makes you makes your acid reflux act up, right? You know that makes you go crazy, right? I'm not allowed to feed you that anymore. Mom says it makes your eyes turn red and your throat start to clog up.
Cool! Fun! Yay!
Who wants to go to recess?
Nah, I'll stay here. Nah, the floor's more fun. Nah, I'm not very socially active.
Where did I fail you?
Is that a big word, Mommy? I said a cool word, Mommy. I said I like pizza, Mommy.
Every day I try. Every day.
I guess you're not trying hard enough. I guess that you shouldn't have divorced Dad.
That's really good. Really good.
Our next game is called Rotating Bats, and this involves Ward, Elena, Ella, and Jacob.
Are going around at any given time, and it is these smart people's jobs to remember where their scene is and entertain you. So for these front two, we need a suggestion for their scene. Let's something that you would be surprised to get as a gift.
A tooth.
Gross. Your suggestion, however you choose to use it, is a tooth. Rotate right. We need a suggestion of something that would be really awesome to have for breakfast, but you never really get to have for breakfast. Shout it out.
Ice cream.
Cake.
All right, there was an overwhelming... your suggestion, however you choose to use it, is ice cream cake. Rotate right. We need a suggestion. Ross, get us one.
We need a suggestion for a funny name for a brand of carpet cleaner.
Flood be gone.
However you choose to use it. Rotate right! Let's get one more, Ross.
How about a suggestion for... delightful vacation location?
Maldives.
Oh. You guys can't
Tahiti.
The Bermuda Triangle.
Oh, Reach is using it. All right, let's review. Rotate right. Your suggestion was?
A tooth.
Tooth. Rotate right.
An ice cream cake.
Rotate right.
Blood
be gone. Blood be gone. Rotate right. What was yours again?
The Bermuda Triangle.
Good. Excellent, guys. Rotate left and begin.
Oh, I can't get this blood out. Looks like I'm gonna need to use some blood be gone.
You got a blood be gone. You can get your blood gone in little about 4 years. Won't take that long.
Watch. With a little bit of editing. It's gone!
Have you heard of what happened to my dad in the Bermuda Triangle?
No, I haven't, Mark.
Oh, John, my dad went to the Bermuda Triangle and he came back.
That would be so wonderful. Can you tell me more?
Well, it's in all the news stories. Like, it's the most popular thing right now. I mean, he came back, he had everything except, well, I mean, he lost one of his brooms, but, you know.
What's your dad's name?
Oh, well, I just call him Dad.
Rotate right!
So, I was down to talk about the kindergartners today, and one of them gave me a box.
Oh, I think we want you to get the money.
I'm not a tooth fairy. Do I look like a tooth fairy?
Kind of, yeah.
Ha ha ha!
Like, what? Like, the other day, she totally broke my leg. Like, look at it. It's moving. Totally broke it. She just won't listen to me.
Sure. Did you get your leg checked out by a doctor?
Trust me. I got all the sorts I need.
All right. But you call the doctor when you get older.
No. Okay, come on. They're boring. All they do is, like, diagnose broken legs. You wouldn't want to do that. So anyway, my birthday party, we ended up having like frosted colored raviolis, and they were awful.
Makes sense. Sweet and savory don't really go together.
Are you saying my birthday party food wasn't good?
No!
Then you are saying that.
I'm just saying that maybe you could have tried pasta noodles with frosting. Instead of just
that was so last year. Like, come on, keep up on the phrases.
Rotate right!
So, how's it going with the tooth? You got the money yet?
No, I do not, thank you. Now, which child's tooth is this?
You know what? If you can't provide the money for a child's tooth as the tooth fairy teacher, you know, I'm gonna have to fire you.
Right.
Okay, so I sketched it all out. This is how we're going to go to the Bermuda Triangle, back, and then back into the Bermuda Triangle.
What about leaving it the second time?
Well, I was thinking we could just stay there, but...
Oh, yeah, maybe we can look for a, you know, desert island and stuff like that.
Yeah. Or we could come back, you know, it's your choice.
Yeah, we'll decide on the way.
Yeah. Okay, let's go!
That's pretty good. Yay! Our next game is a long-form game called a Godot. And this game is going to feature Kelly, Shay, Julia, Kaylin, Maya, Olivia, and Sophia. So if you are not in that group, kind of form a second back line, I guess. And you guys form the main back. There we go. Awesome. All right. So this game will feature two people at once. The two of you step forward. And, all right. So these two people are doing a scene, right? And let's say that Kelly gets a great idea. So she taps out Kaylin. All right. So tap her out. Kaylin goes away. And then Kaylin gets a great idea and Kaylin comes back. So she taps Kelly out. Now when Kaylin comes back, it is up to her to show you, using her acting skills, whether she's the same character from before or if she's a totally new character. This game is going to tell us a story. And the way we know that it's over is when one of these players says the word Godot. That's what we're listening for, all right? Cool, so you guys can step back. And for this game, Ross, do you want to get us a suggestion?
Oh, sure. Let's have a suggestion for a pet you'd like to have 100 of.
A fish.
Fish.
Your suggestion is
cat.
Fish.
All
right. And Tubi?
Now you have to hear what I heard. There's these new kind of fish, and they're only selling them in certain locations. Look here. One there, one there, one there, and one there. And you will not believe what these fish do.
What?
Are you ready?
Yes.
Are you really, really ready?
I'm so ready.
They swim, but they also don't only swim. They can fly, too.
Flying fish?
Flying fish. It's amazing.
How would I keep them in the...
Why can I please get one of those flying fish? Well, of course you can! I've been dying for one of them myself. Now look here, here's where they are. There's one right here, one right here, one right here, one right here. One right here.
Another one from right there!
Well, we better get going! Okay, pack up your bags, get everything ready. I'm gonna call Dad, we'll get this situated. Oh, I'm so excited, we're finally
gonna get... How much are they?
Oh, I don't know, we'll have to look into this.
Honey, I tell you, we need to talk through this.
We really want one. It's so little baby.
Why can't you just give her something normal? Like a snake or a bird.
But a flying fish!
So Dave, your wife wants to get what?
A flying fish. It's I know, it's ridiculous.
Can you say that again?
She wants me to get a flying fish.
Yeah. What?
Hey, did you see that flying fish in the sky? I think they escaped.
I seriously
We're gonna call out an occupation. I'm sorry, I was hired to get your credit card number and your social security number and your name too. That would be helpful. Could you like write it down because I'm not good at remembering things too? Dad, can you mail it to me too? I don't have any paper.
Hi, I'm John. I'm stalking for a government. Well, no. I work for the government. I am not stalking you. Oh, I need to go back to my 101.
World's worst dog catcher.
Come here, puppy. Puppy, be free.